Hello, friends. My name is Michelle Fondin, and I'm the author of the new book, Enlightened Medicine, Your Power to Get Well Now, an integrative approach to healing the seven deadly lifestyle diseases. And welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you're enjoying those chakra videos. The topic for today is on choosing empowering words to co-create your destiny. And I mentioned the other book because I talk about choosing empowering words in chapter 4 of Enlightened Medicine, but I also talk about choosing empowering words in the book Chakra Healing for Vibrant Energy. And that is what our topic is for today. And why am I talking about that in particular? Well, thanks to you guys. I love it when you guys leave comments, when you ask questions, when you send me emails, because oftentimes it sparks a creative idea for a new video. So thank you so much, and continue to ask your questions, make your positive comments, and maybe challenge me a little bit. So this is thanks to one of my viewers who had asked about the word alcoholism and using the word I am an alcoholic or I am an addict in an AA meeting or an NA meeting. So we'll talk about that in a little bit. But first and foremost, I'm writing a book on manifesting your desires. I'm not going to release the title yet, but I'm in the midst of writing that book and choosing empowering words to manifest or co-create your destiny. And why do I say co-create? Because in fact, you are a creator with God. You are a creator with your higher power. So you are actually co-creating your destiny with God and with your higher power. Now, choosing empowering words is an extremely difficult thing to do. So at first glance, you might say like, oh yeah, I choose empowering words. I'm a positive person. I'm optimistic. I talk positive. Well, when you really get down to the nitty gritty of it, when you're really listening to not only the things that you say about yourself, but you're also listening to your thoughts, you're listening to your internal dialogue, and you're listening to your own words, you will notice that for most of us, our self-talk or our internal dialogue is more on the negative side than on the positive side. So why is this so? This is so because we are fighting against an ancient brain called the reptilian brain or the amygdala, which is really that part of the brain that incites you toward the fight or flight behavior, where you know what it is. It's like you get anxious, you get worried, you get stressed, and then you either want to run away or you want to fight someone. So it's this constant battle of the ancient brain that is always looking out to protect you. It's this need for survival. So in this need for survival, you always have this more negative thinking than this positive thinking. You have more negative words than positive words. It's the natural propensity of things. And it's really difficult to train your brain, to train yourself to use empowering words to help you move forward into the future that you want to co-create, and which is so important. It's so important that you choose these words because your thoughts become your words become your deeds becomes your destiny. And everything that you think about, everything that you say will manifest itself in physical form. So you need to be really careful about the things that you say to yourself and the things you think about yourself. Let me give you an example. So I teach this yoga student. She's a great yoga student. She has a lot of potential. She's really good. She hasn't been doing yoga for very long. She is approaching 60 and she talks negatively about herself, saying things like, oh, I'll never be so flexible, or I might not ever be able to do that pose. And I would stop her and I say, stop, no, don't repeat those things to yourself. Of course you'll be able to do that pose. Of course you'll be more flexible. You're doing this, you're doing yoga, you're doing it twice a week. So you will become more flexible. And you need to think about the things that you tell other people, the way you announce yourself. Like you announce yourself like, I am a diabetic, or I am a cancer survivor, or I am someone who was abused. And the way we have our calling card is also a way that can disempower ourselves. Now, let me give one resounding exception to that rule. Many of you who view my videos know that I talk a lot about addiction and recovery, especially alcoholism. And here is the one exception. The one exception is recovering alcoholics and recovering addicts often in meetings. We're not talking about in daily life. That doesn't happen in daily life. But in meetings, they're saying, "Hi, my name is so-and-so, I am an alcoholic," or "Hi, my name is so-and-so, I am an addict." Now, there is a very specific reason for this. It sounds disempowering. It sounds like it is a negativity. It sounds like, how can you identify yourself as an alcoholic or addict and say that that is your calling card? There is a reason for this. I've studied disease up and down, backwards and forwards, all types of disease. That is what I do for a living. I study disease and wellness and how to look at the root cause of disease in order to get well. Addiction, especially substance use and abuse, alcoholism, drug addiction. I'm not talking about other addictions. Other addictions can be really strong, but they don't modify your brain to the extent that drug and alcohol use modifies your brain. It's because you are taking something chemical that is harmful to your body that is really morphing your brain into something else. So addiction is a really crazy animal. Few people have actually figured out how to get people to admit first that they have a problem, go into recovery, stay in recovery, and be in recovery long term. It is something that is so crazy and baffling that it leaves doctors scratching their heads, because to this day, they still don't understand exactly how to get people into recovery. That being said, AA has been around for nearly 100 years. It is the only system that actually works to get people to stay in recovery. They've tried everything and nothing works like the principles of AA. We don't know why. As a medical community, it's very difficult to understand why. From a spiritual perspective, I can tell you that it is God or your higher power or whatever you want to call it that is the one, and it's the steps that guide us into believing, into serving our higher power, that helps people who are addicted in order to recover. So when they say, "I am an alcoholic" or "I am an addict," and that is the phraseology that they are using, even though it seems negative, it's actually a positive. It's an anchor. Why is it an anchor? It's an anchor because many of these people have suffered for decades, not recognizing the problem, being complete denial of the problem, and not recognizing that this is the actual thing that is causing my life to be in shambles on so many levels. It wreaks havoc on your physical health, your mental health, your emotional health, your psychological health, your relationships, your job. Like, it infiltrates every single area of your life. And so that recognition of, "I am an alcoholic, I am an addict," is actually an anchor. It's a positive anchor, because from the point at which they can recognize that they are an addict, then that is the point of recovery. So do you understand how that's a little bit different? Now, if you say, "I'm a diabetic," you can have diabetes as a type 1 diabetes, and like, you have no control over that. It's in your genes, but you don't need to announce yourself as a diabetic. You can say, "I'm getting stronger and healthy in my diabetes." You can say, if you're a type 2 diabetic, "I am changing my diet and changing my life. I'm empowering myself to get healthier." So do you understand the difference there? The difference is you don't have to make your disease your calling card. And typically, like I said, for alcoholics and addicts, they don't make it their calling card unless someone really presses them. If they're in a social situation and someone's like, "Have a drink, have a drink, have a drink, have a drink," they may, yeah, say like, "I'm a recovering alcoholic, like I can't have a drink." But typically, you know, a lot of them are still very embarrassed. And I'd say a majority of them are embarrassed in the general public, that they will never say that in public because it still wears a shroud of shame. So that being said, that is a different category. Let's focus on empowering words for yourself. So if your internal dialogue says, like, "I hate my thighs, I am fat, I am sick, I have this disease, I have lupus, I have fibromyalgia. I have chronic fatigue syndrome. If you're always constantly like saying that to yourself, it's really difficult to move forward in a positive way. It's really difficult to move forward in health. It's difficult to move forward into the life that you want to co-create. So reevaluate the words that you're saying to yourself each and every day, and the words that you're thinking to yourself each and every day. And usually, if you modify your words, usually the thoughts come in second, meaning that it's pretty simple to modify the words that you say once you've trained yourself. Once you've trained yourself to say, like, I am strong, I am healthy. Someone says, how are you doing? I'm fantastic, I'm great, I'm healthy, I'm energetic, I'm strong. You can retrain yourself to say that type of vocabulary versus saying like, oh, I'm so tired. Oh, I need a coffee. Oh, I didn't get enough sleep. Like, we have a tendency to complain, and complaining is just a bad habit, really. And we can change that habit to make a better habit of speaking positivity into yourself, speaking empowering words to yourself, because what you say is what you become. What you speak is what you move toward. It's just a point of focus. And so the same thing is with your thoughts. Now, thoughts are much harder because we're not always watching our thoughts, right? Oftentimes, we're doing other things. We have to work. We have to do the dishes. We have to go grocery shopping. We have to drive a car. And so often during these moments of downtime is when our negative mind or our survival mode mind tends to go into this negative patterned thinking, but we're not always aware of it. So what you need to do is make yourself aware of that negative patterned thinking. And when you start to get that negative patterned thinking, to turn it around into a more positive self-talk, a more positive mindset, a more empowering mindset. One way to do this is have a vocal recording of yourself with positive affirmations. How do you do this? You create these affirmations with the first part of the sentence is, I am strong, I am healthy, I'm dynamic, I am thin, I am rich, I am empowered, I am wealthy, I am spiritual, whatever it is that you want to co-create in your life, you're going to say it in the present tense as if it's already there. Then you're going to take your phone, your electronic device to record, and you are going to record your voice saying these positive affirmations about yourself. And then when your mind starts to go into negative mode, you're going to listen to those positive affirmations. How long? As long as it takes to turn the thought process around. And this can be a daily practice. And for me personally, my positive affirmations are a daily practice. I do this every single day, several times a day, when I have downtime, or what Tony Robbins says, net time, no extra time. When you can take that time when you're in the car, when you're in the shower, when you're doing the dishes, you listen to those positive affirmations. Now, one thing that I mentioned when I mentioned being an addict or an alcoholic, and the problem with denial is that some people might think, is this like being in denial? Like, you're saying these positive things and they might not be true now, but is it denying something that is going on that you need to take care of? And that's not really what this is. What this is taking your words and making them powerful so you feel empowered. And when you feel empowered, you can take action steps towards your destiny. If you're feeling disempowered because you're using words that are negative in nature about yourself, then you have a tendency to not want to take action because you feel disempowered. And when you feel disempowered, you have low energy, you lack energy, and you're sad and you're depressed and you don't want to move forward because you think like, what's the use? I can't move forward. So I always like what Tony Robbins says about positive thinking. And he said that what we do when we talk about empowering beliefs, empowering words, is that we are not thinking about positive thinking. Now, positive thinking is great, but positive thinking can have that air of denial. And addiction is one prime example of that. And he said, you know, if you go to your garden and you see a bunch of weeds and you say, there's no weeds, there's no weeds, there's no weeds, that doesn't mean the weeds are going to disappear. You have to actually get out there and do something about the weeds disappearing. And the same thing for you. So if you're saying, I'm thin and strong, I'm thin and healthy, I'm thin and healthy, I'm thin and healthy, I'm my ideal weight, and you keep saying that over and over and over again, but you don't take action toward that, then of course you could use all the positive words you want, but if you're still eating a cheesecake and Ben and Jerry's ice cream every single night, then you're not going to lose the weight that you want to lose to feel thin and healthy, thin and happy, thin and strong. Do you realize that? So it starts with the positive words. It starts with a positive mindset. It starts with changing your thinking pattern to be more positive rather than more negative. And it's an exercise. You need to exercise your brain for this. And it takes time. It takes time to create these positive affirmations. It takes time to create this positive vocabulary for yourself. Now, that being said, if it's good enough for you, it's good enough for others in your head too. So what does that mean? That means that if you need to speak empowering words for yourself out loud and in your head, then you need to speak positive words for others out loud and in your head. Now, this can be so challenging because our egos take over. And our egos take over and our egos get hurt and, oh, she said this about me and she's thinking this about me and he said this and he really thinks this and he's really just a jerk. We think these things. In the same vein that we want to co-create our own desires, we need to have the mindset that others deserve to have their co-creation of their desires as well. And when we speak empowerment into others, that goodness comes right back to us. So you can't feel good about yourself if you're speaking good about yourself but bad about others. So you need to keep in mind that those positive thoughts, those positive feelings are also being directed toward others as well as yourself. So work on that this week. This is a great exercise. And believe me, I am still working on this exercise. It takes a lot to override those negative thoughts, those self-defeating thoughts, those thoughts of unworthiness, and it's something you can work on a daily basis. And just like exercising a muscle, it gets better and better each time you do it. Thank you so much for joining me. Please subscribe to my channel below. Share this video with friends, family, and your dog. Please support me on Patreon. I don't get paid for doing these videos, but I love to bring them to you. I love you guys. Thank you so much for subscribing. www.patreon.com/Michelle S. Fondin, and I will see you in the next video.